Thomas, why did you want to run for this position?
The engagement and development position is a role that I've been working with for about 4 years here in DCU. Eva McGuire was the first officer, and she was the person who inspired me to be part of the student union. She reached out to me and told me to run for clubs officer because she knew I was an engaged student. And from working on Big Bar with Steve, it was my kind of first dealings with the SU and promoting that campaign and running. I, myself and my friend, went to Rome as the Mad Hatter in Alice, and we raised over €2,000 for it. And then, so I got elected in, and then the next year I worked with Siobhan McTighe. And then I went for a second go at the clubs officer, and I worked with Cara McGovern. And then this year I took a step back, but I'm now the chair of the Club Life Committee. And with that role, we still work in tandem with the Engagement and Development Officer. So I'm working with Katie Fay, and I had previously worked with her when I was on the executive when she was Science and Health Faculty Officer. And when the constitution was going to be amended, and we thought the referendum was going to go through, I wasn't going to run for it, because I'm not doing it for the sake of being on the SU for another year. I'm doing it because the role is everything that I love about DCU. I love getting students involved and getting students developed by giving them those like soft skills such as public speaking, organising, that employers love to see. And that's what I've been working with the club's officer when I was in that role myself. So it's definitely a role, I feel it is built for me, and I may be the last officer in that role. But again, I'm not doing it just for the sake of an extra year in DCU. I'm doing it because that role is me, and if there's a role for me, it's definitely that one.
Brilliant. What would you do differently this year compared to, say, last year's candidate?
Over the 4 years, every candidate brought their own spin to it. So I suppose with Emer, she was the first one. It was a brand new role. It's not like academic affairs or president that it's been going on for years and years and years. It was brand new. It's so niche, and other universities didn't have it. So between her and then Siobhan McTighe, they built the role up with the five pillars of clubs and socks, with engagement, sustainability, the Irish language, to name but a few, as well as class reps. And then between Siobhan and Cara McGovern, they got the class rep system online to vote, which was brilliant because then we got students on placement engaged. And then this year, Katie kind of had the best of all of theirs. So I'll be incorporating her love for sustainability and volunteering, because they're two of her big passion projects this year. And sustainability is something that I think we need to work on. As we know, our climate's in an awful out of state, and it's something that the SU need to be behind. As well as the Irish language was something that Siobhan McTighe was really passionate about, and it's something that I'm passionate about myself. And rather than just an Irish language point to my manifesto, I'm going for an initiative called Gael Talk DCU, which will incorporate Irish history, which, because I'm a history student myself, the culture, dance, music, the whole lot, what makes Irish so Irish, so as potato sandwiches with Brendan's bread as well, and pots of stew, to give our international students a real taste of the Irish identity. So I'll be just really building on the work that they've done, as well as giving it my own niche twist.
And as you were sort of saying, what do you think are the major issues for students today in DCU?
So one of my core focuses is commuter students, because we have a huge population of students. A lot of officers think about the students who live on campus, which is a very minute population. We still have a huge number of beds on our campus. It's still not enough beds, but a lot of the events are engaged for those, so they're on in this building at night time. Whereas some of the events I want to run during the days would be something called commuter cocktails. So a lot of students feel like they're locked out of the student lifestyle. They can't go into Coppers or go out to Flannery's because they've no way home. So I want to run events from, say, 4 to 8, so that people can catch the last bus home, that they can go to these and get involved, as well as more daytime activities with clubs and socks, board games, tea and coffee. And I want to bring the SU out to the students. So rather than having it in this magnificent uni building, a lot of students don't use it and don't know about it. They see that it's built on campus, same as the science building or the T101. So I want to bring events to them by having ones in their corridors and in their own common areas to get them involved. So it's definitely, the biggest issues are getting students involved, commuter students, and backing the rent strikes and the issues with renting, because students aren't cash cows, and it's extortionate the prices they're paying. I know myself, I'm in a house with a few lads, and even what we're paying is scandalous money. Like, when I tell people at home what I'm paying up here, I could have a house at home paying off a mortgage. Like, it's crazy when you think of it like that. So they're the major issues I will be working for.
And finally, why should students vote for you?
So I feel like I have the experience. So I've been on the executive twice and the CLC three times. I'm really good with money and really thrifty, and we have to be on those committees to give students the best quality experiences for the lowest prices. I have a huge contact base now in Dublin and across the country for different events. So at the moment I'm the club host for Copperface Jacks. So I deal with all their bookings during the weekends and work with their events team. I also work with some other nightclubs promoting their events, and I've worked with an agency called Get the Shifts last summer, which seen me all across Dublin and across the country working with various event companies such as Event Dimensions and Orange Works, which have given me ideas and given me contacts to bring really good quality events to DCU, again at a low cost and budget, so we can have more and more of them. As well with our local community, I've been involved with events on in from Conjure and with our community officer. She's now my union mentor, so I've built up those relationships and relationships with various different bodies of our university, which I think is really, really vital for the role. So I'll be going head first in it. I know what I need to get done, what has been done before, what works, rather than someone coming in new to the role that really doesn't understand the role or doesn't know what like different contacts and how to fix various issues and bring solutions to the table.
Well, Thomas, thank you very much for sitting down with us, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.